Hello everyone, I'm Seda Yüksel. Today I'm going to talk about evaluation of the impact of the transparent component on the energy loads and thermal comfort conditions in different climatic regions. Before going to main presentation, I would like to introduce the contents of my presentation. First, I will talk about introduction, energy consumption in building. Secondly, study method, determining assumption for study, and then analyzes, and finally, I will talk about all results of the study in conclusion. Changes in the world after the Industrial Revolution and developments in technology have increased the importance of energy for human life. Increasing population and changes in personal needs have led to increasing demand for energy resource. However, due to the rapid decline of energy resource and environmental problems caused by their use, controlling energy consumption is becoming increasingly important. According to scenarios, fossil fuels will remain to be dominant resource until 2040, although the consumption may partially decrease. When we look at the total energy consumption according to the industries, we see that the energy consumed in buildings, similar to the world, constitutes a big part of the total energy consumption in our country. The percentage of the energy consumed in buildings has reached to 40% of the total energy consumed, and it seems likely that it will continue to increase with increasing number of buildings. In building, heating and cooling needs constitutes a large part of the energy consumption, and it is increasingly important to make decisions carefully during the early design stage, reduce consumption to provide thermal comfort in buildings. Energy efficient designs, reducing the use of active systems which increase energy consumption and improving the performance of passive systems, which lead to less demand for heating and cooling energy. If we look at the built environment variables which affect energy efficient design, the location of the building, its position compared to other buildings, orientation, building form, and optical and thermophysical characteristics of the building envelope. Internal environmental conditions which change with different climate conditions are affected by these design parameters. Orientation of the building, window location, and transparency ratio selected according to the climate conditions are among the most effective factors in the energy efficient design stage. With correct decisions taken during the design stage, interior thermal comfort conditions can be achieved with less energy load and building energy consumption can be reduced. When we look at the study methods and aims, this study intends to emphasize impact of decisions taken during the early design stage to achieve energy efficiency in buildings and minimize the energy consumption. The study consists of four parts. The building was selected first, and then climate zone was selected. Istanbul temperature humid, Diyarbakir hot dry, and Erzurum cold climate. Three cities were selected for the study, and these cities represent different climatic regions of Turkey. Then decisions about passive climatization parameters, which significantly affect energy consumption, such as transparency ratio, window location, and building orientation. And finally, the effects of these design parameters taken for different climatic zones, energy consumption, operative temperature, and solar gains were compared. As you can see, the dimensions of a single unit building evaluated in the study are 5 meter to 5 meter and with 3 meter height and flat roof on a level land. In study, a system running on natural gas was chosen as the heating system, and electrical system was chosen as the cooling system. In the calculations, indoor air temperature was assumed to be 21 Celsius degree in heating period and 26 Celsius degree in cooling period. Calculations of energy loss and thermal comfort conditions in zone were done with Design Builder simulation program, and which runs with Energy Plus simulation motor. The energy consumption of the alternatives will be evaluated on heating, cooling and total energy consumption. Operative temperature and solar gains for use of alternatives were calculated on January 21st, which represent the coldest day, and July 21st, which represent the hottest day of the year, for evaluated thermal comfort conditions of the selected zone. All evaluations are made by using the same single zone building in three climatic regions, Istanbul, Diyarbakır and Erzurum, with 30% and 50% transparency ratios and different window location. Windows are located on opposite walls and windows are located on adjacent walls. This table shows us 12 different building forms were created for each climatic region. When we look at the properties of the selected cities, Istanbul and Diyarbakir are in the second and Erzurum is in the fifth degree day region according to the standard. In study, the same window properties are used for all options and it meets the limit values in standard. The opaque part of the building were created according to the standard second and fifth degree day region value, and the selected city are shown on the map. First one is Istanbul and second one Diyarbakir and third one is Erzurum. Building envelope details are shown in tables. Some materials were used these envelope and only insulation thickness was changed to match required total heat transfer coefficient value in each region. The first graph is for Istanbul and Diyarbakir, and the second is for Erzurum. The material catalog in the Design Builder simulation program was used to select materials. First, we will see heating, cooling, and total overall energy consumption for Istanbul. The alternatives are listed from lowest to highest. The lowest energy consumption for all alternative is north-south 30% alternatives, and highest energy consumption alternative is east and west 50% alternatives. All alternatives overall energy load increase with increasing transparency ratio for Istanbul, and for each alternative reducing transparency ratio from 50% to 30% increased heating energy consumption, and reducing transparency ratio decreased cooling energy consumption. When annual overall energy consumption ratio were compared, north south 50 and south west 30% alternatives and east west 30 and south west 50% alternatives for Istanbul have very similar energy consumption ratios, and thus can be used as alternatives for each other. For Diyarbakir, the alternatives are listed from lowest to highest. The lowest energy consumption alternative is north-south 50% alternatives, and highest energy consumption alternative is east-west 50% alternatives. Overall energy load increased with increasing transparency ratio for all alternatives, but except for the north-south alternative for Diyarbakir. For each alternative, reducing transparency ratio from 50% to 30% increased heating energy consumption, but reducing transparency ratio decreased cooling energy consumption. When annual overall energy consumption ratio were compared, northwest 30% and east-west 30% alternatives for Diyarbakir have very similar energy consumption, and thus can be used as alternatives for each other. And for Erzurum, the alternatives are listed from lowest to highest. The lowest energy consumption alternative is north and east 30%, and highest energy consumption alternative is north and west 50% alternatives. Overall energy load increased with increasing transparency ratio for all alternatives, but except for north-south window location alternative. Except the northeast window location, reducing transparency ratio from 50% to 30% increased heating. And for all alternatives, reducing transparency ratio decreased cooling energy consumption. When annual overall energy consumption ratio were compared, south and east 50% and south and west 30% alternatives for Erzurum have very similar energy consumption ratios and thus can be used as alternatives for each other. When we look at the all calculations, for all alternatives, 1.4 to 25.7% for Istanbul, 1.3 to 41.1% for Diyarbakır and 8.8 to 44.5% for Erzurum. Energy consumed can change in different range. Overall energy load increase with the increasing transparency ratio in all alternatives but except for north-south alternative in Erzurum and Diyarbakır. When the transparency ratio increased in all alternatives except north and east in Erzurum, overall heating load decreased and for all alternatives cooling load increased. When we look at operative temperature and total solar radiation gains, on January 21st are shown with yellow line and July 21st are shown with blue line. For all options, operative temperature for January and July 21st were outside the comfort temperature defined in study. Therefore, it's necessary to use active systems for alternatives. Orientation, window location and transparency ratio have more impact on the operative temperature in the heating period than cooling period in Istanbul. When we look at Diyarbakır, orientation, window location and transparency ratio have an impact on operative temperature both in heating period and cooling period in Diyarbakır. For all alternatives except north-south 50, south-west 50 and south-east 50% alternatives, the operative temperature for January, July 21st were outside the comfort temperature defined in study. Therefore, it's necessary to use active system in these alternatives. Orientation plays a bigger role than the transparency in alternatives in which temperature, operative temperature increased in January and July 21st. For Erzurum, orientation, window location and transparency ratio have an impact on the operative temperature, both in the heating and cooling period in Erzurum. For all options, operative temperature values for January and July 21st were outside the comfort temperature defined in study. Therefore, it is necessary to use active systems for these alternatives. Orientation plays a bigger role than transparency in alternatives in which operative temperature increased on January and July 21st. Finally, today, rapid depletion of energy resource and increasing the energy consumed in buildings lead to several problems. This study demonstrates the relationship between energy consumption and thermal comfort conditions based on the decisions taken during early design stage in different climatic regions and reveals the impact of design decisions on the energy consumption. Priority effects of variables, example, transparency ratio, orientation, and window location on heating, cooling, and overall energy loss and operative temperature of buildings may vary in each climatic region. All alternatives, when listed for overall energy consumption from lowest to highest, were similar ranking in Istanbul and Diyarbakır, but different in Erzurum. There are alternatives with close energy consumption ranging between 0.1 to 0.5% for all climatic zones, and thus it will be possible to achieve flexibility in design and they can create alternatives for each other. For all alternatives, lowest heating energy consumption was observed in Diyarbakır and lowest cooling energy consumption was observed in Erzurum. For total energy consumption, highest values were always in Erzurum, but the ranking can change for Istanbul and Diyarbakır. Although Istanbul and Diyarbakır are in the second degree day region, according to the standard, different energy consumption loads were observed. When operative temperature were evaluated, some alternatives had a lower or higher thermal comfort temperature than the defined in study. Energy consumption can be reduced by choosing options that are close to the comfort temperature specified in this study. In future studies, it's possible to identify the most efficient building form alternative using the parametric evolution method discussed in this study. Thank you for listening.